baby. Where did these niggas be at when they say they doing all this and all that? Tired of beefing you bones, you can't even pay me.
Quels sont les liquides les plus chers au monde? Le sang de limule. Cet animal marin est apparu il y a 450 millions d'années. Les labos utilisent son sang bleu pour fabriquer des vaccins. Mais à cause de ça, l'espèce est en danger d'extinction, donc faut vite trouver une solution. L'encre pour cartouche d'imprimante. Le litre peut coûter jusqu'à 9000 euros. Et entre nous, c'est pas vraiment justifié, parce que l'encre, c'est juste de l'eau et des colorants. Le sperme de cheval. Ouais, c'est carrément dégueu, mais ça peut coûter jusqu'à 600 000 euros. Les éleveurs en récoltent pour féconder les juments et faire naître les chevaux de course. Le venin de scorpion. 10 millions de dollars le litre, c'est le liquide le plus cher au monde. Pour l'obtenir, il faut traire à la main le scorpion et sans se faire piquer. On l'utilise notamment dans la recherche contre le cancer.
Actually, yeah. Full disclosure, I'm not a scientist, but I do love some early human history, and I am a historian. But yeah, white people do have a resistance to cold, that's an actual thing. Or at least northern white people do. And I'll remind you guys that we are more similar than we are different, but we do have small differences. So geneticists back me up on this, but I believe northern white people do have a thin layer of fat over their entire body that helps insulate them a little better in the cold. I mean, it makes sense. That's where we are from. So if we were in a video game, white people would have +5 frost resistance. Unlike my not northern European friend here. So anyways, Skyrim is for the Nords or something.
When you tie your shoes, use a square bow. This is a square knot. Take a look at that. It's symmetrical, beautiful, pulls tight beautifully. Now, don't get me wrong, I love my grandmothers, but this, by long tradition, is called a granny knot. It comes apart. Doesn't hold its shape. So when you tie your shoes, do so with a square bow, one that lies this way across the shoe, and you won't have to double knot. It'll stay tied all day. So if you're going out for the evening, you should tie a square bow here as well. One over the other, pull it back, form a loop, come down from the top, keep your finger there, follow the finger with the other loop, and then dress the knot. Pull it tight so that it looks nice. My name is Nye. Phil Nye.
Human sperm looks like under the microscope. Well, we better find out right now.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna take the sperm sample, put it on a slide, cover the slide.
Oh, shit. Yo, take a look at this shit.
Yo, this is pretty amazing.
Things that are diet culture that you probably didn't realize are diet culture, part one of probably a lot. One, the obsession that women have to have flat tummies. Did you know that we actually have an extra layer that protects our uterus? Your body doesn't care about the society standards. All it knows is that it wants to protect that uterus, and I just think that's so sweet. Number two, this obsession with not having hip dips. Hip dips are genetic and beautiful. Number three, the concept of having a cheat day. Cheat insinuates that you're doing something wrong, and nourishing your body and fueling your body and feeding your body is never wrong. Number four, purposefully ignoring hunger cues. If you had to pee really bad, you wouldn't praise yourself for having willpower and not peeing, right? You would probably go pee, so why do we ignore our hunger cues? Number five, weighing yourself every day. We are not meant to be weighed every single day. Stress, working out, inflammation, hydration status, not having a decent bowel movement can all play into your actual weight, so weighing every single day is just an obsessive tendency that society has created for us. Number six, when foods are labeled guiltless. Guilt is not an ingredient. In Diet Culture 2021.
Is this even real? We better find out.
Then we're just gonna pour this up.
And then we end up with this.
What is up, guys? Now all we have to do is just light it and it should fly up like a firework. So let's do it. Oh, come on. Firework, firework, firework. Yeah! Fly. Woo!
Well, the Skittles have been sitting for 2 days. It's time we did something with them. Now I'm just gonna scoop them into these plastic bags. This step's best with a vacuum sealer, but I don't have one, so I just put them in Ziploc bags and suck the air out. And now it's time for the cryo pack. You don't want to handle dry ice without gloves on, so let me get some real quick.
Like a glove.
Just kidding. Inside the cryo pack, I have 3 blocks of dry ice. I have extra room in the cryo pack, so I'm also going to freeze dry some marshmallow fluff. I put the fluff in first. Now I'm adding the biggest block of ice. Now I'm going to set the other 2 blocks of ice on top and let it sit for another 24 hours. The Skittle's been sitting in the cryo pack for about 15 minutes. Let's see what's going on with it so far. I hate to do this, but come back tomorrow.
Những điều trường học dạy cho bạn, nhưng không đúng sự thật. Ngoài vũ trụ, thật ra, có trọng lực. Tiếng Anh gọi là microgravity. Mặc dù lượng trọng lực này rất nhỏ, nhưng nó giúp cho mặt trăng quay quanh quỹ đạo của trái đất và trái đất quay quanh quỹ đạo của mặt trời. Mình nhớ lúc nhỏ mình được dạy rằng chúng ta có thể thấy được vạn lý trường thành từ ngoài không gian, nhưng theo bạn thấy ở bức hình này thì chúng ta không thể nào thấy được vạn lý trường thành nằm chỗ nào cả. Khi bạn bị chảy máu mũi, bạn không nên ngửa đầu về sau, vì mặc dù máu sẽ ngưng chảy ra khỏi mũi nhưng mà nó sẽ đi xuống đường cổ họng và ngưng đường thở của bạn, có thể làm bạn tắc nghẽn. Nên khi chảy máu mũi, bạn nên bình tĩnh ngửa yên hoặc ngước đầu ra phía trước. Và cuối cùng, cà rốt chỉ giúp bạn say mắt khi cơ thể bạn thiếu vitamin A, còn nếu cơ thể bạn đã đầy đủ thì ăn cà rốt nhiều đi nữa thì nó cũng không cải thiện khả năng nhìn của bạn nhiều lắm.
You right now watching this video, I bet you didn't know that you're related to Will fucking Smith and Charlie D'Amelio and the fucking Pebble himself, The Rock. Even me, oh what the? Here's why everyone on Earth is your cousin. This is a very basic family tree. We have 2 parents, 4 grandparents, and 8 great-grandparents. And this number doubles every single generation. Thus, let me take you back 40 generations. That's 1,000 years. Doing very basic math that I completely did myself with zero help, you would have 1 trillion ancestors alive at one point. You might be thinking, Matthew, 1 trillion ancestors alive at one point, that's impossible! You would be right. The only obvious solution is there must have been a lot of knocking boots between our ancestors. That means inbreeding. However, that's only the start. Humans have been around for 7,500 generations. Meaning we must have this many ancestors, e.g. a massive fucking number. However, since this is literally impossible, we must all share one common ancestor. Daddy. So go on, tag literally anyone because they're now your cousin. Eli!